Welcome, my friends, to part two of section 6.3, just more basics about vectors in the plane. The idea is to really just get used to the basic operations of vectors and to be able to kind of visualize what they mean graphically. So moving on to example three, I'd like for you to graph each vector on the same plane. So where vector u is defined in component form as 3, 4, and vector v is defined as 2 times vector u. So first, I'd like for you to figure out what the component form is for vector v, and then we'll have you graph it. So anyway, there's a lot in this lesson of me just kind of asking you to follow your nose. So I don't especially tell you how to do things. I just kind of ask you to do them. but I do think that that's because if you follow your intuition, you'll probably do the right thing on this stuff. So anyway, some notation. This example, the vectors are typeset. And so I want you to notice that vector u there, instead of having that hat that we give it when we handwrite it, when you see it in the textbook or typeset, you'll see instead of the vector hat, it gets it's bold-faced, okay? But what I want you to know is that when you take notes and when you do your homework and when you show your work on your assessment that's coming up, you're going to need to make sure and always put vector symbols on top of vectors, okay? Don't get misled by the way that things are typeset, okay? So when we type it, it's bold, but when you handwrite it, you need to add these hats, okay? So when you copy this down in your notes, you're going to write vector u, vector v, 2 times vector u, and you even say the words when you read it. You don't just say 2u, you'd say 2 times vector u, for example, okay? So I'm going to go through and fix the notation on all the vectors. Let's make sure all the vectors get their appropriate hats. All right, my friends. So between now and the next video, just throw something at it. Follow your intuition. See if you can figure out what vector v would be there if it's defined as 2 times vector u. Go ahead and draw both vectors on the same xy plane. See if you can figure out what the component form of this vector w would be that would be a unit vector. See if you can guess what a unit vector is. I'll give you a hint, like what's a unit circle? It's a circle of radius 1. So think about what a unit vector would be, okay? Anyway, see how far you can get, and then I'll go through it with you in the next video, and we'll see how much you got. Good luck.